we're sponsoring a new band. It's called The Velvet Underground. And we're trying to... Well, since I don't really believe in painting anymore, I thought it would be a nice way of combining, and we have this chance to combine music and art and films all together, and we're sort of working on that, and the whole thing is being auditioned tomorrow at 9 o'clock, and if it works out, it might be very glamorous.
That he touched, he had such facility of making it a big success somehow. He turned everything into gold.
I be your mirror, reflect what you are, in case you don't know. I be the wind, the rain and the sunset, the light on your door, to show that you're home. When you think the night has in your mind, that inside you're twisted and unkind, let me stand to show that you are blind. Please put down your hand, 'cause I see you.
It's my wife, and it's my life, because a maniac to my vein leads to a sinner in my head, and then I'm better off and dead.
An attempt to be revolutionary, an attempt to combine both the avant-garde and the commercial and try and make a run at it. We rehearsed at one point for a year and a half, every day for a year and a half, and recorded every rehearsal. And I ended up filing down the bridge of my viola and calling it a three-string drone, and put guitar strings on it, and used a bass bow on it, and it would make a noise very similar to a B-52. And together, the thing, when we really started performing it with some power, I mean, it would definitely have a daunting effect on the audience. I was interested in developing rock and roll in a sense that you would incorporate this, both the funky side of rock and roll and the Wagnerian side of rock and roll, and put it together.
But Lou was living upstairs and heard us playing all these blues records and whatnot. At the wee hours of the morning, he had the campus radio show that was on once a week on Saturdays. So he came down to borrow records. And I could hear all this humming and buzzing upstairs. And that was Lou warming up. And then he was just playing as loud as he could with his amplifier hanging out the window. I said, oh, he plays guitar too. I have to talk to this guy. And you know, so I did.
Come on, come on, let's go.
Simple ideas, three chords, turn it up, and make the lyrics be about something. Had to be about something that had to do with everyday reality as we knew it then, as opposed to just nothing or making believe it was about something. I mean, I think when a real characteristic of the Velvet Underground, as I think is about my own songs, is that they're really about something. I mean, that we really care about, that really happen, that have some bearing in real life, and they're not just a disposable subject. I mean, I was trying to give you a shot of some of the street.
Standing on the corner, suitcase in my hand, Jackson's corset, Jane is in her vest. And me, I'm in a rock and roll band. Huh. Riding a stud back at gym. You know, those were different times. All the poets, they studied rules of verse. And those ladies, they rolled their eyes. The Jack, he is a banker, and Jane, she is a clerk.
There was the songwriter Lou. He was rapidly trying to show me all these other songs, but he was playing them on an acoustic guitar, and I said I was really fed up with folk music. The Dylan stuff and Joan Baez stuff, I was quite disinterested in people writing songs that had nothing but questions in them. That it was far better to make a statement than, you know, how many miles must a man. But when I read the lyrics, they certainly were not. I mean, the lyrics to Heroin were certainly not self-pitying.
They're good songs. I mean, they're going to stand up no matter who plays them, but they're nothing like how we wound up playing. Me with my no drum training whatsoever, just bashing away. made a huge difference. Sterling with his nice, quiet little ideas of guitar playing and his real solid rhythm playing, and John with his manic viola. Lou would go off and on a tangent, and Cale would go off on a tangent, and if someone wasn't holding it all down, it would just be this massive confusion. So I would concentrate on just playing the same beat we started at and just keep it under there, so when everybody came back, there was something to go back to.
I think the effect of Venus in Furs is that musically it's so shocking. I think that's what frightened people. That could have been a song about anything. But that always has been my favorite song. That's the, if I had to say, show me one thing that you do differently than anybody else ever did, I would drag out Venus in Furs. I said, you show me whoever sounded like this.
Severin, Severin, speak so slightly. Severin, down on your bended knee. Taste the whip, in love not given lightly. Taste the whip, now bleed for me.
Sometimes I feel so happy. Sometimes I feel so sad. Sometimes I feel so happy. But mostly you just make me mad. Baby, you just make me mad. Linger on your pale blue eyes. Linger on your pale blue eyes. Thought of you as my mountaintop. Thought of you as my peak. Thought of you as everything I've had but couldn't keep. I've had but couldn't keep. Linger on your pain.